Feud subscribe to the live screen sharing room on DAX and watch every day the live trades I do on time during the market hours, the first hour of cash trading and then US session and why I'm taking these trades. You can go on my Twitter page here at this name and click this on the pinned tweet here. This link which will prompt you to a PayPal subscription service which is have a small description here and the first 2 days is free, then you can have free cancellation if you wish so, and then it's just 19 euros a month. So if you click login here, then this will prompt you to a subscription details, and then you will need to let me know about this so I can send you the password and so you can be able to log in every day and watch the live screen sharing. Or you can just go to my YouTube channel here, which I upload every day the video after what happened after the European cash market closed, and this is the link here of the everyday recording after the market closes. So this is just free, you can feel free to go here and just watch this. Okay, hello everyone. So we opened gap down slightly here and opened inside yesterday's to almost 200 point range here, and lining the sun for a long is 600 here, yesterday's value area low and this previous week closed pivotal level, this 600, so looking for a support here to see if a long position for a gap fill, then eventually up to 700. And yesterday's high will be a nice trade, also targeting 680 is yesterday's value area high as well. If 600 yesterday's value area low fails to hold and trades below, then looking for a move for price to balance within this area here and targeting yesterday's low 520-530 area. So let's see how this will play out. Also have some euro dollar upside above 106 due to dollar weakness since Trump failed to talk the dollar higher yesterday. So if dollar index continues to go towards 100 and we have euro dollar going higher, of course this might push DAX lower slightly. So let's see about this. It is indeed a long position here at 600 flush down move. Let's see if this will hold for a move up to initial balance low and breaks out towards initial balance and move higher towards gap fill, then up to 700. This is lining the sun here. If this holds, then this is likely to go higher here. Otherwise, this will just collapse and face lower, it seems. Out of the long here, price is holding below. Let's see if it finds any kind of rebound resistance here or if it reverses back on, I will get long again. I'm afraid this is not going to flash down further. Let's give it some time to see if another long will be ideal. Got long again here, 602s for the same scenario. Need to see if this will hold here. Seems some support, lining the sun for a breakout is to hold the breakout initial balance low and view up and go above, then breakout initial balance high, then a gap fill, then higher. Let's see if this will happen. Entries at 602s here. Flip the position to short here, failing to hold above 600, so stop above 600 for a move all the way down towards 530s. Out of the short position here and flip to long once above 600 for the same scenario. This looks it got absorbed here, so we need to see what it does on VWAP. Key level to break out is 610s here for a move up to gap fill, then eventually higher. Out of the long once again here, let's give it some time to see if this will just chop around here or if it finds direction here. Kind of choppy level at the moment, as this is in the middle of the range, so let's see. Initially the short again 600s again, here we see holding resistance below, so let's see if we have eventually a new low here. This is not finding any kind of direction, but held up resistance on VWAP here and initial balance low now below 600. So let's see if we blip lower. If this goes down to 530, it will be a very nice trade eventually. Flash down, scale out first target 10 points. Need to see if we'll allow this to trade all the way down to 520s. Going straight down here. This area has well traded in the past, so price has no reason hesitating here and just go towards the other side of the range. Scale out second target here, 20 points into the trade. The rest to see if it goes down to 530s now. Okay, so price reversed at the turn of the first of the 30 minute here, so need to see if this VWAP will hold eventually resistance or if it flashes straight up. If it holds resistance, we're looking for a continuation lower. I sorted once more here the same entry 94s as the previous one, in anticipation this will hold resistance and will continue towards the retest of the low of the day and then eventually lower. Of course this can just rip straight through here and go higher, but let's see. Very nice resistance so far, shorted here in anticipation of resistance on VWAP, scale at first target now. Looking to see if we hit a new low, we'll scale out before the new low touch down to 75s, so then leave the rest for further downside. Scale out second target here from the short on VWAP, still holding the other short, now leaving both positions for a move towards 530s. Very nice trade on VWAP here, additional to the first one. If you have a look on the 30 minute chart here, you can see yesterday we broke out to weekly highs here due to Trump enthusiasm before the conference, but then failed again above 700s, now trading below 600s, and we need to see if and what it does at the other side of the range. If once again for 5th or 8th time holds support at 530s, if it doesn't, we should see a very nice move lower below towards 500s later on. Also looking on the daily chart for the same support here at 530s, failure yesterday, hit higher Bollinger Band. So if this is to break out mid Bollinger Band, which is holding support and above generally all these months, should see a move down to 450s, 400s, which is next area of support here and previous high, swing high up here from a year ago. So next support is this 400s if price can go there. But generally the way it trades is just having some pullbacks, but then immediately getting bought, then flashing straight up for a new high, then sideways, then flashing higher. And this is what is doing now on the 1 minute as well. Here we see some kind of absorption here, so let's see. Okay, so first start of cash trading already here, and need to see if we push further down below. I move my stops to break even 93s, then the entries 94s up here on VWAP, and earlier on at this breakdown I scale out twice both positions, but leaving the rest for a potential move lower towards 530s, 500s area, so targeting this side here, and then generally see if this side holds once again support, because this is very nice area of support here, as you see, especially yesterday after the first hour market held support here to the tick, then flashed straight up within a few minutes, like almost 100 points here. So we need to target this way. This is an area of demand here for the market for some reason. So need to target at least tries to go there at least, and then see what it does if it holds support there or not. In case of a failure here, if this is not absorbed anymore and price goes there and then fails, looking for a move down to 480s, which is this before the year sent consolidation high, so perhaps market can find some kind of support down there later on if it goes. Okay, hello again. So let's see where we are. Basically, market just getting absorbed 3-5 times here at 66 and getting always bouncing towards VWAP. We need to see if we manage to break this absorption level here during the US session and give us a move down towards this weekly, how many times this held support here, 6-7 times. If this can go down here and see what it does, this is nice area of support. The question is, will it hold if it goes there once more and then press balance back again? Also, we have a gap in today's session here, so there are two scenarios. One is to see if price holds 66, we'll go long here for a move up to VWAP, then we'll try to hold the position to see if this can grind all the way higher here and go in an attempt to fill this kind of gap. Although as of now, this is just trading lower and lower with a flat bottom here. This is absorption lows here, so perhaps another support here, then price can go higher, especially if we see dollar strength and SPY, also S&P, if it goes higher as well, we need to see at that time. So the idea is to see if this can hold initially for a long towards 600s, then generally to manage to hold this all the way up to 650s. Otherwise, need to see if this will fail here and have a retest and resistance, and this can go towards this 520s, the range of the low of the weekly range here. So let's see. Market held once more here on VWAP. This could be a very nice entry for short, but let's see what does at 66, if it holds one more or just fails and goes towards 530s. Okay, price broke down 66, initiated a long position here in anticipation that this will hold once more here and price will move eventually up to VWAP, then see what it does if it continues higher or if it fails once again. Let's see if this was just a fake down here. Flatten the long here for a few points. Now need to wait and see if price will eventually blip lower. So this was a real breakdown. Seems so. Next area of support should be down 530s, 520s area. See what price does there. So initiated the short position here against these 570s here for a move down to 530s. Let's see if this can continue to go lower. Scale out first target here, 10 points into the trade. You can see one trade doesn't work, then you having minimum risk, then wait for a rebound to go short towards the direction in anticipation this can go further. Need to see how further down this can extend. Straight down here. Also spy, let me scale out more here. Also spy below 226, so looking for DAX to give us a move at least until 520s. Also 500s will be nice if this can extend that far. 520s is very important support area here. Need to see if today is the day which breaks down or if we hold support once again. We have nice selling pressure on SPY here below 226, down to 2550. Also dollars weakness here and euro dollar strength towards 107. Of course, this is pushing DAX lower. Also, you see nice GTK here hit extreme lows here, extreme weakness underlying in correlation with SPY and DAX, which is heading lower. So, this suggests this has room for further downside. Let's see by how much. Key level here to see if price will hold once again this 2023's level, although while Spice heading lower, not sure if we like to buy here, perhaps wait a little bit first. Also, the other time yesterday, which held there to the tick, immediately rallied higher, so need to see if this will be a third bad retest and we go straight through this. At the moment, held support to the tick here. Also, a market statistic I track is the 40% average exhaustion from the first hour of cash trading low today. So this is the range of first hour of cash trading. We extend 100 points from this. This price, in order to extend that far, goes 33% of the time. But in order to extend 40 points, the 40% of this range, it has 72% chances to go. So just there, basically, there it is now. We need to see now how further down this can extend though. Also, looking on the 30 minute chart here, you can see yesterday's failure up to 700s after this pre-Trump enthusiasm. Day one gap down, failed above 600s, now at the lower band of this range here, multiple week. So we need to see if once more this can hold support or if this will break towards 500s. At the moment it's holding support, but need to see what it does until the end of European cash session, which is in 1 hour 20 minutes, so let's see. Flattening the rest of the short position here, perfect support down here. If somebody manages to take this trade long, this can lead all the way up to the other side of the range eventually later on. Not exactly this will happen just right now, but yesterday, once it touched there, you can see in a few minutes, just like 100 points. So now it's already 20 points from the low here, so let's see if it goes up to VWAP here. Not the best idea, it seems, to flatten the short position here, as this is looking like a channel which we need to see though, but looks like it can break further down. Also, SPY towards its lows and no major bounce from there. Also, nice tick here, mostly below zero. And the most important thing, as discussed on the week ahead video, earlier this week, is we have VIX volatility index here going higher than its close to yearly lows here and bouncing. So this is bearish for markets as of now. So we need to see if this will just go towards 500s now. Not the best idea to flatten the short. Do be aware here on the bigger picture on the daily chart. As I said earlier this morning, yesterday we failed above Bollinger Band at 700s level. Now we need to see what this test of weekly lows here will give us, if it gives us a breakdown and generally prices can move below here and hold for a move lower. Then we're looking for a move down to 480s area, then 440s here, this kind of range. So technically now we broke down yesterday's lows. So let's see how further down. Also need to be aware that if price goes above yesterday's lows for some reason later on, I would like to go look for a bounce up to VWAP at the time. Although let's give it some time to see. So initially the long position here against the low of the day for a in anticipation price can move back inside this range. Let's see if this happens. Flatten the long here, no reason to hold, this is straight down. So let's see by how far. So next area of support for this is this 485s level. So we need to see what price it will do if it goes there. Third time failed to hold this week, so we need to see how further down. So price retested the previous low with volume, fake down 500s, now 27 points higher here. need to see if this will be aggressively bought and price centers back above yesterday's low. That was the idea basically, that gonna took this kind of long, although flattened earlier than this sell off here. So need to see now where this will head. Okay, so here we are at the European cash equity close. So Tom says, exciting thing the markets. Yes, this you should expect. Let me know, let me tell you how you should expect exciting days and less exciting days. When we have the indicator for this is VIX, when you see VIX attempting even to go above its current lows here, or generally if VIX is trading above 15 generally, you should see equities having nice ranges intraday, like 70-80 points swings. When you see VIX below 15 here, we have this kind of low volume grind in equities, higher and higher and higher. When of course you see VIX above 20 and having these spikes, you have intraday ranges like 200 points or so. So basically, if we have a summary of today, you can see this gapping down here after this trap enthusiasm rally of yesterday, failing to hold above initial balance area, holding resistance of VWAP straight down, then getting absorbed all day here at 56 and failing again against 600s, resistance of VWAP during US session, breakdown. New low for the day, straight down to weekly lows, now further down towards 500 support, then short covering rally here at the European cash close, 30 points, nice area though. Also you can see on the profile here how we failed to accept value inside yesterday's value area. I said earlier this morning, if this goes below 600, looking for a move down to 530s. Also, this took all day to happen. Other cases can be like a few minutes to go further down.